here we are at the Florida National Association of Mopars, being hosted by the Don Garlits Museum of Drag Racing in Ocala, Florida, only on Muscle Car Madness. 1967 Sox and Martin was the baddest Mopars in town. Now we got Paul Harsh, who's built a replica, a clone, if you want to say, of the original Sox and Martin car. Paul, tell us about this particular car and why did you build it?
Well, I was a fan of Sox and Martin when they first started on the Plymouth scene about 67. I fell in love with their 68 car, and for the last 4 years, we've been putting one together, and it's a 475 cubic inch Hemi. It's stroked and bored a little bit. We try to maintain the 68 look with the 21st century technology of electronics and new design of the internal parts.
Right.
And the car moves out pretty good. We believe that it will match their 68 record of 1064 to 134 miles an hour.
Right.
At least that's our ET goal for the car.
Right.
But it is a street car. It's built for 93 octane gasoline. And I drove it here this morning about 30 miles.
And that's Racers for Christ I see on the side. So don't let anyone fool you that Jesus people like race cars.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We go fast for the Lord.
That's right. Sattelbird. Yeah, I haven't made a mistake, and you're not seeing anything. The man who owns this car, we're going to get the lowdown on it, Bob Muff. What in the world is a Sattelbird?
Well, this is just a crazy idea that I had a few years back. to come up with a car that Chrysler never built. I just took a 66 Plymouth Satellite and fabricated everything to make it look like a Superbird. Called it a Saddlebird because it's a satellite, and that's about all it is.
And it's a one-off car?
Nobody ever built one like it, and we've had a lot of fun with it.
Well, I like it. I don't know if I could drive it on a daily basis, but I sort of like it.
If anybody doesn't like it, hey, let them build their own.